The Philippine Trade Department, looking at the country's emerging electric vehicle sector to help give the local economy a much-needed boost amid the COVID-19 pandemic. In a webinar organized by the American Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines, Trade Undersecretary Rafaelita Aldaba said, attracting more investments in the local EV sector can help ease unemployment in the country.
By promoting this industry, we'll be able to create not just more jobs, but better quality jobs, meaning the salaries are higher, and at the same time being able to attract more investments to help in our recoveries.
In April, the country saw its highest unemployment rate on record, 17.7%, which translates to roughly 7.2 million Filipinos. Aldaba also says pivoting towards sustainable industries like electric vehicles can make the economic recovery more inclusive and resilient.
It's not only the recovery that we are focusing on, but at the same time, what we're trying to do is to make use of these stimulus measures such that we're able to address both economic as well as the environmental aspects.
But unlike some countries which included the EV sector in their COVID-19 stimulus packages, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian admits the proposed local economic recovery plan did not include the sector. That is why he says it's important for local lawmakers to pass the Electric Vehicles and Charging Stations Act, which he authored. Aside from providing a local regulatory framework for e-vehicles in the Philippines, the bill will also incentivize the local manufacture and import of EVs.
The whole point of the incentives is two fronts. No? Number one is to make it affordable. Number two is for the country to reach what we call the first mover advantage.
As for policymakers, the Energy Department says it's now working on regulations on e-vehicles in anticipation of the proposed law, including preliminary works on a charging infrastructure development plan. These are seen to be up for public consultations in the next 12 months. If the bill sees the light of day, officials expect the local EV industry to be developed in the next 3 to 5 years. In the meantime, local EV manufacturers are eagerly waiting for the passage of the bill.
We, as an industry, are capable enough to address the number of commuters of more than 100 million Filipinos who badly needs a mode of transportation that is systematic, that is more affordable to use of, and that is reliable.
The Trade Department aims to have 6.6 million EVs in the country by 2030, or around 21% of the total expected 32 million vehicles. With incentives and a clear regulatory framework in place, it targets to have 49% of the EVs in the country locally manufactured. Bruce Rodriguez, ABS-CBN News.